So I'm like a word
student.
How, okay, first of all, how do you like Anche's dress? Anche, this dress, check it out. This is fantastic. Let's hear it for Anche's dress. It's a great dress. Where did you get that dress? Where did you get the dress?
All on the market for dresses.
Well, I'm going to dress in drag if dresses are that great looking. Where did you get it?
I can sell it to you.
Absolutely. Where did you get it? You probably got it in Amsterdam. Is that Germany? In Germany? In Amsterdam? You did it where? In Berlin, probably.
No, actually, I got it in a little town that my parents are from. It's just like a 3,000.
What's the town called?
It's called Pilsner.
This dress you got in Pilsner? Oh my God, Pilsner people, the fashion capital of Western Europe. Who knew? Who knew? Okay, so anyway, how is everybody tonight? Doing well.
We each have our lives.
I'm just so thrilled that so many people stuck around. I mean, it's kind of flattering, you know? Anyway, Anche, if you want to talk, Anche, don't let me get in the way. You go ahead. You go ahead and talk. You need to talk into the mic. They would never hear you.
No, it's not true.
You could never hear me, right? If I had the mic.
Oh, well, that's right. Actually, you should ask the questions.
I should ask the questions, okay. How far is Pilsner from Berlin? Because when I go to Berlin, I got to bop over to Pilsner and cop it. Look at that dress. Is it not great?
It's amazing.
It's so great.
So,
you're welcome.
Very true. Christiana's right. So, exactly. Well, it's late. It's late and it's a long day.
Oh, it's early. It's early. We're going to go for hours, people. So just know.
It was all three of you. It was really amazing presentations. Really enjoyed all of your presentations. And really, just one or two questions, which is A, I wanted to ask about the inspirations for the piece. So where did you start? Tell a little bit about that.
Sure. I started, this work has a few beginnings. The first one was learning that my great-grandmother was a black Indian root worker. And many of my ancestors have died, especially the women in my family have died very young. So I started just doing a lot of internal work around premature death in my own family and what that has looked like and what it has meant to not have elders in my family. And being in having a similar relationship to plants and medicine and spirituality as an ancestor that I didn't know felt like a really compelling place to start to research and learn some things. The second beginning was taking that through the Black Seminole and Maroon communities research and its connectedness or the language of their several hundred years or 150 year fight for sovereignty and land and freedom felt very similar to a contemporary conversation around anti-Black violence. So it's now also kind of taken on a lot of language that relates to contemporary violence.
It's taken from the diary of Samuel Pepys and then Annie rewrote this segment about this episode between Sam Pepys and Deb Willett and his wife Elizabeth. And that's what that is.
In a sense, I guess it started here when we were doing the manifestos thing, like the structure of it, what I did, the mic, and going to the mic, and because it was going to be here. But I think that it's really the beginning of what I'm working on. It comes from partly from having spent the last few years working with a large group and being in a place where I am struggling financially. So I can only make work by myself right now. So it's out of need. I can only, and I'm barely rehearsing I'm not rehearsing. This was my rehearsal, basically. I mean, that I don't mean it to be a smartass. It's really, I've been working with my dancers in this process of trying not to treat them as the workers to create a product. So then I arrived at a place in my career and my personal life where I got separated. I have sons. I'm struggling financially and as an artist, even though I've gotten a lot of recognition and I have gotten a lot of grants. This is very personal, but it's really why where this piece comes from. So that song that I started singing is a song, a very traditional song from Venezuela, where I grew up. Although I'm from Uruguay, I grew up in political exile in Venezuela. Venezuela is right now in a really deep crisis and struggling a lot. And it's that song is about women hitting the mortar, like with the corn in the fields. So it's kind of about women's work. And I guess personally, I'm struggling with issues of the hardship of being a mom and alone and an artist and trying to make a living. So I'm making work. And it's I'm trying not to be like victim. I'm also really working on not taking on the role of self-pity. But through my work, I'm trying to use my work. I'm trying to not separate and make the work that is healing for me and it's empowering and that flips the power. So the mic, the phallic nature of it, and the power that having the mic and speaking has and the maleness of it. And not to be like fuck men or anything like that at all, but yeah, I guess it's a process of my process of what I make work about. So I could go on.
Well, one thing that I saw in all three of your pieces is that there's something very painful. So pain, I thought, played a big role in whatever ways and forms. And I was wondering what role pain, ritual, mythology, and all that plays in your work.
Oh wait, who?
Or
mythology?
Or and ritual and pain and all of that.
Pain is rather universal in some senses, I guess. Mm-hmm. But I got a feeling that someone else could answer this question better than me. And maybe they're sitting up here on the stage, which would be great.
Okay. Pain and pleasure, it's funny because I feel like I'm also working with pleasure. Like I've been working with the practice of being in pleasure. So, but I guess pleasure and pain are very connected, very close and slippery. They slide in and out of each other. Maybe it's because it's, for me, maybe it's the beginning. So I guess there's something, if you talk about like making art as a kind of healing practice, we were talking about that in the panel before, so I'm stuck in that. And I do make work from that place a lot. It's a kind of not just as art therapy, but not just as a kind of, I'm gonna get this out so I feel better, but as a process of undoing some kind of thing, or more like as a shift of perspective. I guess the pain, I don't know, I mean, I hope it doesn't seem like I'm just like, poor me. I think that you go through expressions of pain when you're busting out and somehow. Also, I think that I hope that there is an empathy, that the audience gets to, that there is a, in experiencing with someone some aspect of pain and pleasure, that there is an empathetic experience that the audience gets to have, and that allows them to purge some of their own stuff and get to more pleasure.
I'm holding on to mythology as as a part of what you asked, because I think pain arises in the process of making things, because I'm trying to be honest, and there's a lot of pain in the world, and if I'm trying to experience the world in my body in an authentic way, then I'm present to pain, but I'm not trying to make work from that place. So it shows up because I'm trying to be available to everything that is there, and pain is one of those things. And the idea for me of creating a mythology feels really important because there, I'm essentially talking to people that, you know, lived 100 years ago, and I can't know what their words were like or what their movement was like, and a part of imagining a future for myself is to create that, and to look at writers and artists and folks who are creating in that kind of, you know, cosmological futuristic space. You know, who are the people who are doing that, and what does that look like, and how can I dream in that way? So a lot of the writing is a big part, clearly, of the process that I'm in, is about that dreaming and mythologizing. And what I hope becomes a space where I'm dreaming and mythologizing in my physical vessel as well. Like, how am I doing that in my body becomes a question for me. And it's kind of a dual process that I'm in right now, is figuring out like how much of this writing wants to be heard, and how much of it is just the page, and what does the body want to pick up. And I think some of it is trying to find out, you know, how much of the pain is on the page, and how much of that is physicalized, and how much healing can I engender through both.
Thank you. So just in case one of you has a question. So otherwise, thank you so much for coming, and thank you so much for your pieces.
Thank you, Ancha.